York Knicks going up against the Toronto Raptors. I'm Brian Anderson at the table with Grant Hill and Brent Berry. Our reporter is Allie LaForce. And here's the upcoming schedule for the New York Knicks. On Wednesday, they'll begin a road trip starting in Indiana, going up against the Pacers. Then on Friday, they'll be matching up with Drew Holiday and the Milwaukee Bucks.
And for that game against the 76ers, it's the second game of a back-to-back, so you know there'll be some heavy legs out there. Playing that much basketball in that short amount of time really takes its toll on your body.
And let's go straight over to the sideline for a report before they tip off. Hey, Allie.
Brian, the Knicks are making a nice turnaround under Coach Tom Thibodeau. He said, quote, "It's a proud organization. I was here during the 90s. That doesn't have anything to do with today. Just like I don't want us looking ahead. I don't want us looking behind. Our focus has to be exactly on what's in front of us. Guys."
That's a great point. Thanks, Allie. And two conference rivals facing off here. Grant, what were some of your fiercest rivalries at the NBA level?
You know, when I was in Detroit, it had to be the Hawks and I think probably the Bulls. I think the Bulls were everybody's rival in the Eastern Conference back then. And then, of course, in Phoenix, we had some real battles with the Lakers.
So let's take a look at the starters for the Toronto Raptors. Barnes and Siakam in at the forward slots. Goran Dragic is out there with Fred VanVleet. And it's Birch in at the five. And for New York, Barrett plays the small forward with Randall in at the four. Evan Fournier is out there with Kemba Walker. And it's Robinson in at the center. And that one's good.
Inside, Siakam gets the better of the defense using his agility, clearing himself a path to a shot.
Pass to Walker. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
High percentage look right off the bat.
Fournier against VanVleet. Here he goes. Count it. One for one to start the game.
And I absolutely love the attack mentality, even with the bigger defender on him.
Yeah, that's an awesome finish there for sure. Not allowing that big guy to have his way or alter the shot.
Fournier with the bucket.
Well, if you're giving up that much height, the only thing that you can do as a defender is to foul him.
Dragic against Walker. Siakam outside. Shoots over Randall. And there's Siakam. That one's good. On the assist from Dragic. Siakam's got his second bucket of the night. Pass to Randall. Outside Robinson. Walker for three. Drills it from deep.
Well, how about that? The big man, Mitchell Robinson, able to find a teammate.
The Raptors have gone 3 of 3 out of the gate. Here's Barnes. Boom! He jams it straight down.
That lack of defensive intensity is not going to stop a player of his caliber from scoring.
Here's Walker. Sweet little floater. Walker's got 7 points in the game.
And they can't miss. 4 for 4 and warming up the burners.
And when you talk to folks around the league, no one has a bad word to say about Walker. He's just a good guy, a loyal guy.
The three from Barnes. On target from range. He's got 5.
And keeping everyone involved early. Now, that typically pays dividends.
Yeah, and he's so-so from there, but when he's hitting from deep, it's a big confidence builder.
Now here's Randall. And that one's good. And, of course, Kemba's won the NBA Sportsmanship Award multiple times.
Yeah, he's such a glue guy. I mean, he brings people together. He's a guy who improves the culture of your team.
And good, as it takes a nice bounce off the right iron and down.
Wow, on fire. They haven't missed a shot so far.
Walker against Birch. Deflected. Here's Robinson. Always a nice way to start. Makes his first one.
Mitchell Robinson, one of those guys who you could be blocking out, but it's just not enough with that length.
VanVleet with it. We saw him go on a scoring rampage last game. He was unstoppable. And Siakam gets it to go.
Starting to find his rhythm. He's cooking, and he knows it.
Yeah, right now I don't see any let up. I think he's going to just keep putting his foot on that gas pedal.
And it's Randall with the jam.
Well, Randall can get up there with the best of them. It's a quick move.
Barrett against Barnes. Over Barrett. Great look there, but off target.
He may not be the strongest inside presence in the league, but still, he's got to convert from there.
Robinson gets the bucket.
And this is where Robinson will do damage. He's got the height, he's got the length, and when he's inside, he's going to capitalize.
Here's Van Vliet. Outside Barnes. Six to shoot. Pass to Siakam. He's got it. 4 for 4 now. He's automatic.
I mean, the stroke looks good. He's moving well out there. What a sensational start to this game. Perfect from the field.
And here is Barrett. Oh, Siakam with the block.
And the coaching staff, they love this. I mean, Siakam, he's engaged, aggressive, just getting after it on the defensive end. That's 3 buckets in a row off assist.
So it's the Knicks now, after the basket by Toronto. Here's Walker, and it's Dragic with the rebound. The Raptors with a lead. Siakam outside, Van Vliet with it, and Walker picks him up defensively. And the shot's good. Van Vliet's gotten his 3rd basket of the night.
And the evolution of Siakam continues. Seeing him make great passes like this proves he's only getting better. Ooh, scary thought.
Now a timeout called by New York. They're fresh off a win against the Pelicans.
They were so consistent from the 3-point range in that one. And that's a nice weapon to have as a visiting team.
Yeah, the interesting part was they kept firing away in that game, but the defense didn't make much of an adjustment.
And the Raptors making a change here. Achua's checked in for Birch. Boucher comes in for Siakam. And Anobi, he's checked in for Barnes. And it's Trent in for Van Vliet. Rose can't connect. We've got 1:28 left in the opening quarter. Back to Boucher. And finished off by Boucher.
Just great work at finding the open man, Dragic, with his head up.
Halt the run.
Oh, yes, sir! Oh, that's what you tune in for right there.
Wow. And he jams it home with authority.
And they keep trading punches. Both teams in a groove early.
Who's going to miss first? Every time one team scores, the other team right back at you.
Just an awesome display of athleticism on our AT&T 5G Slam Cam. And Dragic, here we go. And that one makes him 2 for 2. He's in his rhythm.
An outstanding first quarter from the field.
Rose against Dragic. Tries a 10-footer. That one a little long. Pass to Trent. There's 38 seconds left in the first quarter here. Over Rose. And it's Toronto with another.
That's exactly the shot they're looking for.
New York has gone 1 for 2 from beyond the arc in this first quarter. Here's Burks. And connects on the 9-footer. 24 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Quickly against Trent. Five to shoot. Dragic outside. 3-pointer, no good. And so it's the Toronto Raptors leading by 6 as we wrap up the quarter. And it's mostly due to their superb shooting. They've wasted very few possessions. More 2K action in just a moment. And the 25th pick in 2020, Emmanuel quickly made an immediate impact with his shooting, including his deadly floater.
I feel like I developed it kind of at a young age. I wasn't always the most athletic, so having skill was really important. So just having that floater that I could, you know, use over a big man is really vital.
Well, Grant, those silky floaters don't always make the highlight reels, but my goodness, are they impressive.
B.A., for a lot of players, that's a bad shot, but it's one he's worked at and perfected over time.
If you're just joining us, we played through one quarter in this one. All right, well, a look at how the points have been generated so far. A scoring breakdown for Toronto.
We've seen a lot of their points coming off penetration in this first half.
I'm loving the ping-pong action of the ball tonight. A decent number of assists so far.
Emmanuel Quickley is out there with Derrick Rose. Then there's Alec Burks. Then it's Nerlens Noel. And it's Randall in at the power forward position. That's the group for New York starting the second. Good on the shot.
That's a big boy play from your point guard there to absorb the hit and still get the shot to go.
Here's Rose into the lane. Count it. And that shot gets him in the books. He's 1 for 3.
Sometimes it's simple. Put the ball in the hands of your scorers and let them do what they do best.
One thing about Derrick Rose that's never changed over the years, Grant, is his ability to come through in the clutch. When a big basket is needed, he's the guy you want on the court.
Well, how many times have we seen it? End of game situation, Rose in an isolation set. And even against a double team, he finds a way to shake free and get the bucket. As dependable as it gets when the pressure's on. Beautiful setup on the alley-oop.
Great catch, great flush. Trent with it. Randall's in his pocket. Trent goes in, uses the glass on the layup. Trent's got 4 points this quarter. New York trailing. To the paint. And it's Randall that time on the assist from Rose.
And guys, the way this defense is getting manhandled down low, you have to wonder if they're at 100% right now.
Dragic against Noel. Back to Dragic. His fourth make in 5 tries. Solid start for him.
Terrific patience around the paint area from Dragic there. Calmly knocks one down from the interior.
Now a timeout called by New York. This game against Toronto here, it's their first look at the Raptors.
Yeah, they got swept by this team in the season series last year, which goes against all logic.
A big group substitution here for New York. Robinson, he's checked in for Randall. Barrett comes in for Burks. Fournier's checked in for Quickley. And it's Walker in for Rose. A big group substitution here for Toronto. Birch, he's checked in for Achiuwa. Pascal Siakam comes in for Boucher. Barnes, he's checked in for Ananobi. And Van Vliet is subbed in for Dragic. Here's Van Vliet, following the bucket by the Knicks. Sends it home from three-point land. Trent's got 9.
That's pretty much not how they want to defend the three-point line. Somebody's got to shadow him out there.
Here's Walker. Some solid defense from Van Vliet.
His touch from mid-range, that's almost always good. That won't shake his confidence.
That one's good for 2. And now it's a 7-point Toronto lead.
I just think that's trouble. You're gonna let that guy shoot layups. You're asking for it.
Fournier finds Walker. Here's Barrett. Yes! Great play by Walker to set it up.
Well, Barrett doing a good job. Defense really draped all over him on the inside. And he got creative to score there.
Here's Van Vliet. Banked it in off the glass. Give him 8 points now.
That right there, that's what their goal is. Get high-quality looks.
Outside Walker. And for players these days, a lack of shooting can be a big hindrance. Grant, would you be more concerned by struggles from the perimeter or the free throw line?
I'd be more concerned with struggles at the free throw line. I mean, if you struggle there, you can become very, very tentative out there on the court. And opponents can foul to force your hand.
And a quick pause here. Let's go to the 2K leaderboard and check out last season's best shot blockers. Second, Nerlens Noel. Chris Boucher, 4th.
The way these two guys patrol the floor, it's impressive. It changes how the offense attacks, especially inside.
The first free throw is good.
And Nerlens Noel, since coming into the league, seemingly has fought an uphill battle to try to find a role on a team where he can consistently make key contributions. Let's hope it's now.
That one misses.
and dominating at a mid-major university. Some scouts questioned Siakam's level of competition during the 2016 draft process, especially since his numbers were so good.
Now here's Trent. He's got 9. Again gets it to go. He can't miss. 5 for 5.
And despite the height disadvantage, oh my, he just attacks that interior.
Yeah, no stopping him on that play. Sometimes even the taller defenders are helpless to stop him.
Stolen by Siakam. It's a 3-on-3 fast break. Oh, got a piece of it. Robinson with a steal. Outside Walker. Count it. He's 4 for 8 now. Also affecting Siakam's draft stock, huh? He was 3 or 4 years older than many of his peers.
Well, what's interesting is that player evaluation has become such a science. But sometimes the variables can lead you astray, and you have to go by the eye test. Siakam was in that cohort.
Walker against Van Vliet. Nice shot by Walker. Walker's got 11 points.
And that's just nasty right there, guys. He has a tremendous crossover.
Trent outside. The 3. Good. And Van Vliet gets the assist.
A massive reason they're winning. This guy hasn't missed a shot. Not one.
New York shooting the ball 70% on this game. Walker for 3. The shot won't fall. So the Raptors will take it the other way. They're moving on after a tough loss they took at the hands of the Pacers.
On the road, they got owned defensively. They just couldn't match the activity level of their opponent.
Well, let's hope there isn't any carryover from that letdown in this one.
Fournier goes in. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down.
And just a lack of fight right now on the defensive end.
Right? At least on that slam it was. That's one way to let a team back in the game.
You have to credit the aggressiveness offensively, because that's when you make a play when you really need it.
Now here's Fournier. He had 16 in the win against the Pelicans in New Orleans. Count the basket. He's got 13.
They're punishing those late defensive rotations, getting good looks inside throughout the half.
Trent against Fournier. Van Vliet outside. Barnes against Robinson. Here's Birch. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. And the Raptors lead by 9. Walker against Van Vliet. And here's Walker. Over Birch. And so it's Toronto. They have a nice 9-point cushion at the end of the quarter. Their key to consistency has been their dominance in the paint. They've been the more physical team. Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Well, Coach, this first half has been a struggle. What's been the problem?
Lack of intensity. We're back on our heels. They're attacking us. We're not getting much done.
Guys, they'll look to be the aggressor in the second half.
Allie, as always, thank you. We'll be right back to begin the third quarter right after this.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and the Jet, Kenny Smith. Let's get to it.
It's Toronto with the advantage at the half. They have a 9-point lead. Shaq, what was your takeaway on Toronto?
They're running the offense beautifully this one, working for good looks. Their confidence looks sky high. It's going to be hard for that defense to disrupt their flow at this point.
And over to Kenny. What'd you think about New York?
The energy on D was a disappointment. They were slow to rotate. Communication was bad. No effort. I mean, the intensity on that end of the floor, where it needs to be, was just not there.
And that'll do it for our halftime report. Stay tuned for the second half, about to get underway.
And we played through the first half. Plenty of basketball left in this one. One guy who's been getting it done is Gary Trent.
Yeah, he played such a smart first half, maximizing his opportunities offensively.
Yeah, I'm thinking back to the first half and wondering, did he take a low percentage shot? Everything efficient.
Well, for those just tuning in, thanks for being with us. Second half of this game still to play. Second half underway. Here's who Nick Nurse has got on the floor. Barnes and Siakam in at the forward slots. Goran Dragic is out there with Fred VanVleet. And it's Birch in at the five down low. Outside Barrett. And it's off the back of the rim. No good. Toronto has gone 3 of 4 from distance in this game. And he's going for the oop here. Out of bounds. It'll be New York's ball. It's the 2K leaderboard showing the teams with the most points off turnovers last season. Toronto, number one.
Their defense led to offense, and no team was better at forcing miscues and capitalizing at the other end.
New York trailing. Fournier, the pass to Randle. Left side, Robinson. Over Barnes. Robinson can't hit. And it's the Raptors with the ball. It's off to Washington after this one, where they will face the Wizards. That'll be the back end of a three-game road trip. Here's Burks. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket is good, and he'll go to the line.
A wonderful look from Dragic, who nicely set up one of his guys for a great look.
Trying to claw their way back into this.
And the best way to do that, minimize your mistakes and take good shots.
Randle outside. And again, the Knicks missing.
Stumbling to start the second half. Three straight misses.
Pass to Siakam. Shoots over Walker. And there's Siakam. That one's good. On the assist by Barnes. Barnes has got his fourth assist in this one. Up top, Walker. He's guarded by Birch. Nice shot by Walker.
Yes, finally one drops after the 0-of-3 start.
Here's Toronto with the ball. They've only allowed 2 points so far in the second half. Robinson against Dragic. Pass to Birch. Shot clock at 6. Over Fournier, and the Raptors getting another bucket right there.
Since half, there's been a stark contrast between these teams. I'm talking about efficiency at the offensive end.
Yeah, this team did something in halftime, going from a mild-mannered half-court executing team to some heroic shooting in the second half. Disappointing as a player to have such a great game and still be trailing. Not over yet, though.
And he's really silencing all the haters. Randle has become a guy you can run the offense through time and time again.
Timeout called, the Raptors. And Randle effectively became a point center starting last year.
And coach put him in spots where he can make easy reads. So Randle knows exactly when to attack and when to look for a teammate.
So for the Knicks, Burks, he's checked in for Barrett. Quickly comes in for Fournier. And Rose is subbed in for Walker. Now here's VanVleet. Give him 8. Driving inside. That one falls. VanVleet's got 10 points in the game.
And now almost all their points coming from the paint.
Inside. Randle. That one falls. Nice feed that time from Rose.
Yeah, Randle does a good job. His frame alone helps to create some space just with a little pivot there, able to find a way to score.
And he's going for the lob. Achua with the dunk.
And the lead increases on a crazy offensive sequence.
Man, the dunk alone would have been incredible, let alone the fact that it came off a 10-point pass. Yep, that one goes.
Well, Robinson staying with the shot. I feel there was definite contact on the play, so not easy to get that one to go down.
Outside Ananobi. And the Raptors, another 3.
And they've come out of halftime
really on a roll. For New York, they've gotten 4 of 7 shots to drop in the third. Down low. And a big finish by Robinson.
Yeah, throw it anywhere you want. Mitchell Robinson knows what to do.
Van Vliet against Quickly. Boucher, left side. Dragic outside. And he drains it. A solid 5 for 6 now.
He drops yet another dime, just facilitating this offense like a maestro.
And stolen by Boucher. Outside Ananobi to the left wing. Dragic passes to Van Vliet. Outside Ananobi. Pass to Boucher. Back to Dragic. Shoots over Burks. And the shot no good. A bit short. The Knicks have gotten 5 of 8 shots to go in the third. Quickly finds Rose. Randall outside. Left side Robinson. And the bucket counts. And he is on his way to the line. He'll try to make it a 3-point play. All right, guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Raptors?
When they've had a chance to attack the basket at any point in this game, they've taken it.
Another thing they've done well tonight is to share the basketball. So many of their buckets have just been off crisp offensive sets, setting up their shooters.
The Knicks making a switch here. Noel's checked in. Free throw good, Robinson.
Well, at the time, Robinson's journey to the draft was such a big story, but now the story is getting bigger as he continues to improve his game and dominate the inside of NBA play.
Now here's Trent. He's got 16 to the middle. Achua with the dunk.
Attacking the rim with power.
Tremendous finish for New York. They've gone 6 for 9 in the half. 1:43 left in the third quarter. Here's Rose. Takes the 12-footer and hits it. Rose has got his second basket of the night.
This is the range Rose is comfortable from. A point guard who likes firing more from 15 feet than 25.
Trent outside. This one for 3. The Knicks pull it in. We're off to battle the Pacers after this one. And they'll be playing at Bankers Life Fieldhouse. That'll be the first leg of just a 2-game trip for them. Rose with the bucket.
Yeah, so reliable. He clearly needs to be more involved in the offense as they try to shrink this lead.
Quickly against Trent. Pass to Boucher. Back to Trent. Score that basket. His 8 out of 9 shots here today.
Now that play never gets old. The pick and roll will still be an offensive staple 100 years from now. Trust me.
Robinson passes to Quickly. Oh, there's the alley. 30 seconds left in the third. Boucher outside. Back to Dragic. On the take. That's basket number 6 in 8 tries.
Well, when Dragic gets the opportunity to drive, guess what? He's driving. Foot on the gas pedal there.
Trent against Quickly. Three-pointer. Hits the three-pointer. Quickly's got 5 now. And as we end the third quarter, a great game. Both teams playing well. It's the Raptors up by 9. All right, we're going to step aside for just a second, but join us right back here for the start of quarter number 4 next. All right, let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
You know, I'm kind of stoked that this was a choice because I love this pass. A remarkable find. He put his court vision on full display.
Well, a great job with the eyes. And what separates great playmakers, as we know, is peripheral vision.
And this is it. Glad to have you along for this fourth quarter. Fournier the two, Barrett at the small forward. Nerlens Noel out there with Julius Randle. And it's Walker in at the point. That's the five for New York right now.
Love his shot selection. Good at taking quality shots. Whether he's defended or open, he knows how to knock those down.
And it's Fournier penetrating. Count it. Good.
Well, if you came here looking for a scoring battle, I think you made the right choice.
Yeah, both of these teams locked in on the offensive end. Going to be a high-scoring affair tonight.
Got a piece of it, and it's stolen by Noel. It's Barrett on the wing. Outside Fournier. Here's the teardrop, and he lays it up and in.
When the player gets a feel for that floater, it can really make things tough on defenders. You're just not sure how to guard him and where your point of commitment is.
Now here's Birch. Here's Barnes. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play. Van Vliet checked in for Trent.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
That free throw good from Barnes. The Knicks shooting has been incredible. 72%. Got a hand on it.
They've had a slight leg up on the boards and a big leg up on the scoreboard.
And it's blocked by Noel.
Noel in there to intimidate and does so there.
And it's Randle with the jam.
Oh, yeah. That'll do it.
Wow, an emphatic two-handed slam. Dragic finds Van Vliet. Over Fournier. And again, Toronto no good. The Knicks have gone 3 of 4 in the fourth and looking confident on offense. Pass to Noel. Back to Walker. To the inside. Randle. Yes! Great play by Walker to set it up. Walker's got 4 assists now tonight. The Raptors have gotten half of their attempts to fall in the fourth. 2 for 4 now. Toronto calls timeout. And I'm sure the players will be staying hydrated with some Gatorade during this timeout. It's so important that they maximize their ability to recharge during a short break like this. The Knicks making a switch here. Robinson's checked in. And let's swing it over to the sideline and hear from Allie.
I had a chance to find out what Nick Nurse was discussing with his players. He said, we've got the upper hand, so let's not waste it. Keep getting stops. Keep finding buckets. So the message is, it's not over yet. Back to you.
And Allie, thank you for that. And it's the Knicks with the ball. Following the bucket by the Raptors. Outside Barrett. Pass to Randle. Falls 8 of 10 and scoring with confidence.
Now Randle is looking like tonight he's capable of taking on the whole offensive load.
It's Barnes on the wing, guarded by Barrett, and the whistle blows as the basket counts. Chance at a three-point opportunity here. One free throw coming up.
One shot.
Barnes, no good on the free throw. And one big difference for Randle now, his ability to finish with the right hand.
Well, it's opened up a whole world of possibilities as Teams just want him to go left. If he spins back and feels confident, he'll use that right hand to get a finish.
Here's Van Vliet following the bucket by the Knicks. Burts the pass to Van Vliet to the paint. And there's Siakam. That one's good on the assist from Van Vliet. Van Vliet's got his sixth assist of the night. Fournier finds Walker. Now Fournier. Ooh, he's locked in. Drains his fifth shot in his many attempts.
Man, that's now 10 straight points in the paint.
I'm not sure what's happened to their defense, man.
Van Vliet outside. Pass to Birch. Another basket. He's now 6 for 7 in the contest.
You just can't give up looks that close to the rim.
Walker with it. He's picked up by Birch. And he lobs it up to the rim. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touched by Randall.
I'm not sure what happened there. You just can't give away possessions in this league.
Here's Dragic. Down low. And Birch slams it in.
Oh, great teamwork right there.
Hey, you gotta love the finish. Bringing it down with some attitude. Randall inside. Working on Siakam. Randall, good.
That's a good try on defense, but with a scorer like Randall, it's just not enough.
Barnes against Barrett. Now here's Barnes. Defense right on him. And that one, good. Barnes has got 7 now in this quarter. Randall against Siakam. Puts it up from 12. And it's New York with another.
Yeah, that's one way to get back into this game. Keep getting him the ball and let him make the shots.
Barrett against Barnes. 1:42 left in the fourth. And that one is stuffed right through.
Even with the score as it is, he just keeps coming at you.
1:39 left to play in the fourth quarter. Pass to Barrett. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim.
And really good focus from RJ there. I think that improves his percentages.
Van Vliet against Fournier. And it's good for 2.
And no one really crashing down on the backside. A breakdown defensively.
Walker against Dragic. From 12 feet. Randall, good. Randall's got 22 points. 1:11 left to play in the fourth quarter. Outside Barnes. Back to Dragic. Van Vliet outside. That one falls. Great assist by Dragic. And the Raptors lead by 11.
And the clock will wind down on this one. Just a solid effort and a good win for the Raptors.
Well, Grant, I don't know if there was one deciding factor in this game, but I'd say shooting accuracy if I had to choose.
Agreed, B.A. They really went after quality looks and shot the ball with confidence.
And this one concludes with their second victory of the year.
And against a familiar opponent, it's nice to establish a psychological advantage with a win in the first game.
Heady play there from Randall. He knows that contact is coming, so he gets himself into position, draw the foul, and still score.
Free throw drops for Randall.
After being picked 7th out of Kentucky back in 2014 by the Lakers, you remember Julius Randall, an auspicious start to his career, breaking his leg on his very first NBA game. That has not deterred him.
Here's Flynn. Good on the 13-footer.
And they came in here with some attitude, and it brought out their best play.
Yeah, looks like a veteran team tonight, getting out on the road, playing with assertiveness, confidence, fully in control for this win.
So it's the Raptors winning this one easily. Boy, a nice win on the road. By the time this one was winding down, this building was stone cold silent.